Hi, I'm Patricia from Trisha's Lovely Creations, and today we're going to create a beautiful bracelet and pendant necklace using Ojoy Creation cutters. Here's her card. And today she'll also take off 25% off your total order using the code TLC. Here's a black version of the bracelet we're going to be making. Today we're going to be using white. We're going to be using nail foils on these. And you'll also need some UV resin. So let's get going. I about forgot to show you the pendant necklace. This is the necklace we'll be making. So it matches the bracelet. Now we can get going. Okay, the first shape I'm going to do is the diamond. And I forgot to put on my cornstarch, so hopefully this comes out alright. Okay. I'll go ahead and do the other one. That one worked, so we'll try it again. There we go. Peel that away. I got a coffee cup here. That's what I'm going to put them on to bake. And very carefully lift them up. And apply to your coffee cup or jar or whatever you've got. I am not worried about the edges right now. We'll worry about them later. Sorry about that, I forgot to turn my phone down. I got a little hair in there, so I'll clean that up with alcohol and a Q-tip. No biggie. Okay, now we'll do the X, and I'm definitely going to make sure I put my cornstarch on for that one. As soon as I can find my brush. And I'm just going to dip it in my container and then powder it on. Okay. There we go. There we are. Should have redusted that. Didn't have as much on it as I thought I did. There we go. Mix that one. There we go. Find my line. Carefully lift them off there. Again, don't worry about the edges. We'll take care of that when they're done baking. I know I had that shut off. And the other one. I'm real sorry about that. I really thought I had it shut off that time. Okay, now we'll pop it in the oven. Well, no we won't. First I gotta get rid of the hairs that I have on there, and then I'll pop it in the oven. Give me just a minute. Okay. Now I'm gonna try to get rid of them hairs. I've got one here. That was easy. Looks like I might have one there. There we go. Let's smooth that out. There we go. I think we're good to go now. So I'm going to pop it in the oven and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back and now we're going to pop them off the cup and clean up the edges and we'll make backs. And I'm going to clean up the edges with my craft knife. Most of these I can probably just scratch off with my nail. All right. There's that one. So you also want some head pins or eye pins, whichever one you got. You want to take one and curve it so you match the curve. Get your cup or jar, whatever you're using, and wrap it around it. That way you've got the right shape. Your other one leaves. You don't want to leave it straight. I'm not doing the straight one this time. So you want to curve them all. Don't pay no. Never mind me. I did the test one and I tried it with the straight, which didn't work out. There we go. Be right back. Okay, I'm back and I've got my clay. And if I didn't mention it before, which I will probably put a note up in the video, these are rolled out in the thickest setting. So I remembered to dust this with cornstarch this time. There we go, there's one. Gonna dust it again. And there's the other one. I forgot to turn my phone down again. Sorry about that. And there's the other one. Pull that off. Find my blade. What I do with my blade. Give me a minute. Okay, got my blade. Wow, I just realized that changed. That's a big difference. And I'm going to put a little bit of poly paste on here. And when I say little, I mean little. You don't want it all yucky and runny. You just want a little bit. Just want it tacky. Sorry about that. just want to sandwich them together. Sorry, I keep getting out of view here. And what I'm going to do is actually texture the back with my fingerprints. If you want, you can use a sponge or whatever, but I'm just going to mat it down with my fingerprints. Now I'm going to just rub the edges over. Just smoothing it over. Okay, do believe that looks good. So for the next one, I'm little bit more poly paste. Very little. That didn't stay, did it? Not that time. Well, I guess this time I'm going to be chasing it down. Trying to get that set in place. Pardon me. I think I got a hair in there. Dang it. Try to get it out now while I can. So I don't push it in any deeper. Alcohol. My Q-tip. There we go. Okay, now that one is good to go. I hate using white, I really do. But I needed to get out of my comfort zone and use something that I don't normally use, which is why I'm using white, and also the nail foil that I've got to go on this set is gonna look absolutely beautiful on white. So that is why I'm using white. So I'm gonna get this stuff moved and then we'll do the X's here. Okay, now onto the X's. And I'm gonna adjust this with some cornstarch. Okay. There we go. Here's one. Dust it again. Okay. Here we go. Pull that off. Grab an X, again with the poly paste or baking bond, whatever you've got, or even liquid clay. Just make sure it's very little. Put a pin in. I guess I need to do that first. That would help. Okay, try that again. Sorry, just trying to make sure I get everything in the right spot. Just fidgeting with it. And this one you're going to really need your silicone tool or something to get down in here and smooth it out. Make sure that that's in the middle. And just like the other ones, we're going to pull over the edge. I make sure everything's where I want it. Okay. I might have to fidget with that once we're done. I don't know why I threw that over there.
I go through so many Q-tips when I'm using light clay. I should take stock in the company or something.
Okay, that should be dry enough to touch. Hopefully I don't get more dust all over it. Okay, I think that's good. Now for the last one. Some poly paste, just a little, Okay, now we're drying up. Just gonna start pressing in my thumbprint texture. Go. Where did I get the green from? Take a Q-tip and get that off of there. Oh, it's messing with some green while waiting for that to dry. That's probably where it came from. There we go. Okay, so we're going to pop this in the oven at 275 for 1 hour. And I'll be back when they're done. Alright, I'm back and they are out of the oven and they are still piping hot. So I'm going to let them cool and then I'll pull the pins out and we will get started on adding the nail foils. Okay, and they've cooled enough I can handle them. So I'm going to pull those out. Bent that one up a bit. Okay. Now just let them finish cooling down the rest of the way and we'll get to applying those nail foils. And what I'm using is XKJ Professional Nail Art Star Glue. You can also use E6000 Extreme Tack. That'll work as well. But I'm going to be using the nail glue today. And it goes on white and disappears clear. And I'm going to have somewhat of a little hard of a time seeing it go clear on this white probably. On the black it was real easy. But I think on this white it's going to be kind of hard to see, so I'm going to let them set and rest for at least 10 minutes. That way I know that it's good and ready. Still a little warm, so I'll be back when they finish cooling. Well, I guess while that's finished cooling, I'm going to show you the paper I'm going to be using, or the foil I'm going to be using, not paper. Okay, I don't know how well you can see it, but it's got that little hologrammy thing going on. Well, if I can get it in the shot here, and it's kind of purplish pink. Here's some beads that I got out to try. Got some of these, which I'm thinking about using because it's pinkish purple, and this has kind of got pinkish purple. They're called amethyst, I think is the name of those. Or I got these. I'm definitely using the silver. I got these light purple ones that I'm really not thrilled about. Or I got these. They're okay. I think their name is Amethyst also. And they kind of got a mirror effect on them. I like them better than these ones. So if these don't work, I might use these. And then I got three big ones for the bracelet. Here, let me show you. So it'll be pretty much this pattern. Well, I can get you in the shot here. There we go. So 2 to 4 millimeter. I believe that's a 6 millimeter rondelle. I am not sure what size that is. I think it's might be a 10. Might be a 10. So, yep. Then the pattern repeats. So, that's what I'm doing with these. So that'll give you time to collect your beads and get together what you want to use and your nail vaults. And if you didn't notice, these are the bigger ones. I'll show you a regular size alongside of it. Well, I just unwrapped them all. So there's a regular size on it compared to the big sheet. So you want a big one. That way you don't have to put down multiple layers. You get just one clean, smooth go at it there. Ooh, and those are finally cooled. Okay, let me put these up and I'll be right back. Okay, let's go to the side. I love this part. This is the fun part. I used to do nails back in the day. Believe it or not, I had long, natural nails. And I'm not kidding you, they had to be an inch long or more. They were really long. Most of the time, unless I would break one, but it wasn't too often I did that. But I wish I had these back then. But I used to hand paint my nails in all kinds of different designs, and I really wish I had the nail foils back then. But yeah, this makes this right up my alley. I'm gonna zoom out some here so you can actually see what I'm doing. And I'm going to start with the X. Oh yeah, it's hard to see it. And if you can tell by my shaky hand, that's why I don't do nails anymore. Because you're probably sitting there thinking, how in the world did you do nails with shaky hands like that? Yeah, I don't. I stopped doing my own, gosh, I don't know, long time ago. (Clears throat) Okay, I think that's got it. Now we'll just set and let this dry until it gets tacky. Like I said, I'm not going to be able to tell when it disappears, I don't think, on the white. So I'm going to let that set for maybe 10 minutes or so. And then I'll be back to put the nail foil on. Okay, I'm not back to put the nail foil on yet, but I am going to put it across this one. And cut off what I need. Find my scissors. Well, if I can get my scissors to work correctly. And I'm totally not in the shot. There we go. And one and two. Go. And I'll be back. Okay, I think that's good. Somehow I got it on there too. Okay. Whoops, sticking to it. I'm going to kind of pull it taut here. Make sure I'm lined over it real good. Lay it down. I had some sticks for this. I have no clue what I do with them. So I'm using my fingers, my fingernail. Pardon me. Trying to see past the glare here too. Okay. That didn't go down right. For some reason it's not wanting to come up there. This way, let's see what that does. Mm-hmm. Maybe I didn't let it set long enough. That piece is not wanting to go down right. Not sure. The rest of it did. Pretty. Okay, so now we'll do the next one. I guess I'll let it set a little bit longer. I might have been premature on the 10 minutes. Voila! And that's how it should be done. Just gotta let it set and dry long enough. I get too impatient. Like a kid at Christmas. Okay. Beautiful. Now we'll move on to the diamonds. Okay, and they seem to be dry, so go ahead and apply these nail foils. There's that one. And now we'll resin them. I think I did say in the beginning this was going to be UV resin, I think. Brush my UV resin. I am using Decorom UV resin. And I think today I'm going to see if I can do two at once. Ooh, I can't do two at once. That'd be much easier. Okay, I'm just going to put a little bit here on my tile. Got my paintbrush. And then we're just going to brush it on. Sorry about that, didn't realize it's so far out of view. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit more. just happened to see a spot that needed some resin when I had it turned like that. Just double checking it here. Okay, I think we're good to go. I'm gonna go put this under the UV light and I'll be back. My brush and alcohol is great for this. If I can find my dip, my bottle. Good as new. And I need to set my timer. Mine says that it takes 2 to 4 minutes to cure, but it takes like a half hour to cure. Okay, the X's are done, and now we'll get started on the diamonds. Beautiful, beautiful. Maybe making sure my tile's clean here. A little drop. I'll just go and I'll put these under the UV light and I'll be back when they're done and we can start stringing them. Okay, I'm back and they are done under the UV light and now we can start stringing our bracelet. And today I am using Stretch Magic cord 0.7 millimeters. And don't forget to stretch your string here, or your cord, excuse me. Let it rest. And I like to do it again after it rests. I do it about 3 times. Okay, so let's get started here. My X on. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to start with one end and work to the other. There we go. Beautiful already. Now, if you don't want to do this on a stretch bracelet, you can do it on a regular cord and put it in a clasp. And instead of using one of these at the last one, you would omit this and put it in your clasp. And I'm just going to double check my measurement on that. Maybe. Might be too big with these in there. We'll see. That looks all big. It might be about the same size. Excuse me. That rest a minute. and do it one more time. And let that rest. Then to make it more secure, you can add some glue, which, or you could add nail polish, either one. I'll probably do that. Gorgeous. Beautiful. Now we'll do the necklace. Oh, I didn't get everything out I needed for that though. Give me just a minute and be right back. Okay, I'm back. Now put together the beads for the headpin. Now the beads for the pendant on the headpin. Wow, I missed that. There we go. And I forgot something else too. I'll be right back. Okay, I think I have everything now. No, I don't. I forgot to get another jump ring out. one way, one the other. There we go. And I've got about 18 inches of cord here. Somewhere between 17 and a half and 18. Now we're going to glue these on end caps. I'm using E6000. I just kind of brush it over that end there. And just kind of twist it. Push it up till I see it come out the end there. Then pull it back down a little bit. There's that one. And twist, it comes up, pull back down, there you go. Okay, and I still forgot my clasp. I'll be right back. Okay, now I got my clasp, and that should be it. One way, one the other. One way, one the other. Put on my clasp. And back together. Go. All good to go. Beautiful. There she is. absolutely gorgeous. I just love these cutters from Joy at Oh Joy Creations. They're beautiful. Hard to work with, but well worth it, I think. So if this video was helpful to you in any way, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I also have a new group called Trisha's Lovely Creations, and I'd like you to join us there. And don't forget, if you shop Oh Joy Creations using the code TLC, Joy will take off 25% off your total order. So thanks for watching. Have a great day.